This is a mess, y'all. There are so many twists and turns with this, and I was not expecting this. So before we get into today's video, I did want to let you guys know that this video is for educational purposes only. Please remember to be kind to everybody everywhere, in your everyday life, in your home, in the grocery store, and especially in the comment section down below. Please do not show hate to anybody, anywhere. Good morning, my lovelies, my beauties, my friends. My name is Christina and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, thank you so much for clicking on this video. I really hope that you will subscribe, stick around, take a chance, and hearing some things that I have to say. And if you are a returning subscriber, y'all already know, y'all are my babies. So good morning, good morning, good morning. How is everybody doing today? I hope you all are having an amazing day. I hope you all had a wonderful weekend. Hope everybody is doing good and feeling good. It has been a very rainy weekend here in Florida where I live. But right before the weekend, it has come out that they are going to charge Alec Baldwin with a crime for the accident or incident that happened on the set of Rust back in October of 2021. If you guys are not all caught up with this, I'm going to just have to assume that you guys are. I'm going to give you guys a quick overview because I am going to be following this because I am pretty intrigued by the fact that they are actually going to charge this man. And they're also going to be charging the prop master, which, spoiler alert, definitely seems like it makes sense to me. But I'm going to give you guys all my opinions on everything. So just stay with me. And I'm going to tell you guys about the twists and turns that just had me shocked. So Alexander Ray Baldwin III was born in April of 1958, and most of you guys know he's an American actor, comedian, and a movie producer. Alec is married and he has 8 children. This is actually his second wife, but he's a busy man. He's got a lot of kids. He's doing movies, been doing movies for a long time, and now has even gotten into the producing side as well as the acting. And that's exactly what he was doing on the set of this movie, Rust. Now, he was producing it. It's allegedly a low budget film that he was filming with a very small crew out in New Mexico, like this desert area, and it was a Western movie. One of the cinematographers that was on set and was working with Alec, and who Alec claims to have been really good friends with, said that he went out to dinner with her and her family and with his family, and they were very close. Her name is Halyna Hutchins. Now, Halyna was a 42-year-old mother and wife who moved to the U.S. from Ukraine. Her friends from the Ukraine described her as spirited, someone whose talents propelled her from that country to the success in Hollywood, but she was a woman who never forgot her home. She was proud of her heritage, and they said that she returned home regularly to visit. Now, before we get into the incident, something that I think is going to make this a little tricky and may actually end up coming up in court later, I don't know, we will see, is not long before this incident that happened on October 21st of 2021, there were crew members from this set of Rust that allegedly walked off the set, said that they did not want to be there, that the conditions were not safe, and that they were staying in like a hotel or something that they didn't like, just a bunch of different things that crew members walked off the set and they allegedly left. Now, there's been a bunch of rumors, so I kind of want to wait until the trial happens before I go into that aspect of it, because Alec, of course, says that that's not why they walked off the set. It was a different reason, but then they said this reason and da-da-da-da. It's going to come out later, but I do feel like that's interesting because if they did walk off of the set because of safety precautions, that could actually end up hurting Alec and his prop master later. So on October 21st of 2021, Alec was getting ready to shoot this like scene with this prop gun. Well, I mean, obviously it was a real one, but he was using it as a prop and they had real weapons on the set. And honestly, I didn't even know that they did that. I don't know, maybe I'm just a ding dong, but I didn't realize that when they film movies that they used real stuff. I thought a lot of it was like CGI. And then I also wonder, maybe because this was a low budget film, they were using real stuff versus CGI, because maybe that's more expensive. I don't know. But nevertheless, Alec was getting ready to do this scene where he was going to be having the wedding. and shooting it in this Western scene of a movie. And there's three people that's involved in this before the incident. Hannah, the prop master, is supposed to be in charge of getting the props together, making sure that they have blanks or, you know, dummy bullets or whatever you want to call it to put in the props. And then it goes from there to the assistant director and then into Alec's hand. From what I understand now, all three of these people have a responsibility to check the prop, which was in this case a gun, to make sure everything was safe. However, Alec said that he has been in scenes like this a million times. I mean, I'm exaggerating. He said another number, maybe 400 times, whatever. He's been in these scenes because he's been an actor since like the early 90s and the late 80s. He's been an actor for 30 plus years, and he's been on sets like this where he's used props like this, and it's always been fine because people do what they're supposed to do. This time, the prop master, Hannah, loaded the weapon, and she said that she loaded it with blanks, okay, so he could do the scene. She then set the weapon on a table. From there, Dave Halls, who is the assistant director, picks up the weapon slash prop and checks it, sees that it's okay. He would later go on to say that he don't know if he checked every chamber. He can't remember, but he checked it. Then he handed it to Alec and said it was a cold gun, meaning there was nothing in this, nothing to worry about, cold gun on set. He hands it to Alec, and this is when Alec starts getting ready to rehearse and get into the scene. Halyna Hutchins, who again was the cinematographer, had her camera ready to get the shot. This is when Alec said he faced Halyna so she could get the shot head on. He pulled it out, and he says that he did not fire it, that it went off.
Take the gun out in the rehearsal. Really, he wanted very dramatic and very sudden, kind of sneak up on them. The barrel clears the whole, turn and cock the gun. I turn and cock the gun goes off. Okay. It's supposed to be a cold. Nothing. Joel is my friend. I'm one of the producers on this movie. Mm-hmm. We've developed this movie together for 3 years. I left my wife and 6 kids in New York to come here for a month to shoot this movie. And I'm the one that shot the gun today that had a live bullet go through that woman's body and into his body. And I need to know, how did that happen? Where did that bullet come from?
Trigger wasn't pulled. I didn't pull the trigger.
So you never pulled the trigger?
No. I would never point a gun at anyone and pull a trigger at them. Never. Never. That was the training that I had. You don't point a gun at me and pull the trigger. I feel that someone is responsible for what happened, and I can't say who that is, but I know it's not me.
And the FBI did check and said, listen, this did not fire on its own.
Baldwin's claim directly contradicting an FBI forensic analysis, which says the gun could not have been fired without pulling the trigger. Prosecutors say he is completely responsible for Hutchins' tragic death. Listen.
We definitely believe he pulled the trigger. The FBI lab report confirms that, so definitely the trigger was pulled.
Somebody pulled the trigger, whether you meant to or not. Nevertheless, it happened, and when he did, the bullet went through Halyna, it hit her, went all the way through her, and then hit another one of the directors behind her. The other director ended up being rushed to the hospital and did survive, but however, Halyna passed away. Now, the 911 phone call is brutal to hear how panicked they are. Again, they're out in the desert. It is so wild. Alec was outside getting sick. It had to have been a nightmare. Whoever's fault it is, no matter what, it was a terrible, negligent accident. And I still want to know how those live rounds even got on the set, because it is said now that allegedly when they went through and checked everything, not only was there the live rounds on the table, in the weapon, but also in Alec's belt. I do believe, and I'm not taking up for him by no means, because he's got some ways about him that I definitely don't agree with, just like every other person in the world, right? Like, you got things you like about people and things you don't like about people. I've really liked some of his movies, but some of the things he says and does is like, eh. But nevertheless, he is probably, as a producer and a long-term actor, he hires these people and trusts them to do their job so he can do his. And I can't imagine the nightmare that, first of all, for Halyna's family. No husband and child sends their wife off to work to be a movie cinematographer and expects for this to happen. You're shooting a camera, for a Hollywood movie. She probably loved her job. Probably the best job in the world. Super cool to do. Be with all these actors behind the scenes, not have to be in front of the camera. And I just cannot imagine that phone call. It had to have been like a nightmare. Like, no way. Like, this really happened. So since this incident in 2021, it has been a mess. I mean, the media has chased down Alec. I mean, he has looked a hot mess. And I can imagine he's probably mentally tore up. And also, Alec was very vocal about being against guns, period. And so for this to happen, it probably messed with him too. But he was pretty confident that he was not going to get arrested. And I'm actually surprised that he is going to be arrested for involuntary manslaughter, okay? And the way that that charge carries in New Mexico, because there was a firearm involved, if he does go to trial and gets found guilty, he will get a minimum of 5 years in prison. Like, he's going to prison if he gets found guilty. So he is going to be arrested for that, for those charges. And so is the prop master, Hannah. I'll get to her in just a second. But that middle guy, Dave Halls, the assistant director, remember how we were talking about three people being involved? The prop master, she put everything together, put it on the table. Dave Halls grabbed it, and then he handed it to Alec. Well, he has already taken a plea deal. Dave Hall, the one that yelled cold gun, went ahead and pled guilty to negligent use of a deadly weapon. He ended up getting a suspended sentence, 6 months probation, but he has to testify against Alec and Hannah. So what? What is he going to testify? So this is why, at face value, looking at it, I'm not really understanding why Alec is being charged with this. But they gotta know more than what we know. For that guy in the middle to testify against Alec, what is he gonna testify? He's the one that yelled cold gun and handed it to him. There's gotta be some more stuff that's going on.
Mr. Baldwin had a duty at the base level to never hold a gun and point it at a person while pulling the trigger. But he also had a duty as an actor and a producer on that set to have the bullets checked or to check them himself to make sure that they weren't live.
Allegedly, the FBI has text messages. So who knows if before the incident happened, if people were texting Alec and being like, hey, things are not safe. I think that there are live rounds, or if there's anything like that that's found, he's going to be found guilty because it's going to seem like, okay, you knew this. But it has to be something. It has to be something. Now, the girl, Hannah, I don't know her, never heard of her. She could walk past me in Walmart, and I'm not going to know who she is, okay? But I definitely think she should be held responsible. Literally, that was her job. It was her job to make sure there are no live rounds on set. And she didn't do that. So I understand her being charged, but the fact that she put it together, she hands it to the middle guy, and then they hand it to Alec. I don't know. We're going to see. It's going to be interesting. Now, the twist and turns of this. So, not long ago, Alec ended up being in a civil suit with Halyna's family, which makes sense. And they ended up settling. Well, allegedly, like very soon, this month or next month, they were supposed to start filming this movie, Rust, again. So Alec was going to go back to filming, you know, like almost 2 years later, things are calmed down, they've settled out of court, and whatever. Come to find out, the husband of Halyna was going to be a part of the movie and producing or something, according to the New York Times, allegedly. Just listen to this.
But the New York Times reporting, according to an unnamed source of theirs, quote, as of Thursday, the movie was still on track to be completed, with Mr. Baldwin in the lead role, and Joel Souza, who was wounded in the shooting, returning as director, and that, quote, the project will include on-set safety supervisors and union crew members, and will bar any use of working weapons or any form of live ammunition, including blanks, the person said. Film production was set to resume this month, with Hutchins' widower named executive producer as part of a wrongful death settlement.
And I was shocked to hear that. But not just that. To make the twists and turns even more just like, Halyna Hutchins' family attorney released a statement allegedly on behalf of the family and said, we want to thank the Santa Fe Sheriff and the District Attorney for concluding their thorough investigation and determining that charges for involuntary manslaughter are warranted for the killing of Halyna Hutchins with conscious disregard for human life. Our independent investigation also supports charges and are warranted. It is a comfort to the family that in New Mexico, no one is above the law. We support the charges, will fully cooperate with the prosecution, and fervently hope the justice system works to protect the public and hold accountable those who break the law. I was like, oh my gosh, so wait a minute. So they settled out of court, so they got some sort of settlement, which is definitely deserved. Then he was going to, allegedly, according to the New York Times, the husband was going to go and finish producing this movie. But now that they're arresting him, I don't know. It just seems strange. The only thing I can think of is they know stuff about Alec Baldwin that has not been released yet. And I want to know what it is because I'm nosy. I want to know what he did that was so negligent that in front of the whole world, they are going to arrest him for something that he says wasn't his fault and was an accident, which, mind you guys, just because something is an accident doesn't mean it's illegal. And that's kind of scary because accidents do happen. But that's why you have like a murder charge. That is with intent. But you have all kinds of manslaughter charges, involuntary, meaning total accident where somebody's life was lost. So just because it's an accident doesn't mean that it's legal. What do you guys think? I'm gonna be following this. I feel horrible still for Halyna's family, obviously. I saw videos of her and her son together right after this happened, and she has one child, a little boy, and he was so close to his mom. And in the blip, she's gone. It's very sad. It's gonna be interesting. I bet you one thing. I bet you everybody else in Hollywood right now is checking their stuff before they get to using anything. I bet everybody is like, whoa. Okay, so I told y'all what I think. I'm standing here in the kitchen on Sunday afternoon, and I wanted y'all to hear what my husband thinks. So what do you think? Do you think Alec Baldwin should be charged?
I think that the very minimum should be negligent homicide. He pointed a weapon, whether loaded, unloaded, prop, at somebody. That's negligence.
Yeah.
And there's even rules, like on set, that even in the gun scenes, they're like not actually pointing the gun at the person. They're off center. And he literally pointed the gun at a person. Like, yeah. You don't, even if that's just like standard gun safety. You don't point a gun at anything you don't plan to destroy. That's, you know, that's negligence. And it resulted, his negligence resulted in a homicide. That should be his charge minimum.
Wow. That's a good point of view. Mm-hmm. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Other than that, I will see y'all on Friday. Thank y'all so much for being here. I love you guys. I appreciate you guys. And I will see y'all soon. Bye.